Dear students, hearty welcome to BioMaster channel. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is Principles of Inheritance and Variation. It is one of the most important chapter in biology. It belongs to the unit Genetics and Evolution. You know, genetics is an important branch in biology. What is genetics? What is its importance? What's the various fields and scope? We should learn all these aspects. But before that, we have to understand and familiarize with some fundamental terms related to genetics to avoid confusion. So, this chapter will become more easy and interesting to you. Okay? Now, let us start with an example. Imagine a baby was born in your family. Then your relatives and friends will come there to meet the newborn baby and mother. They will express their happiness and give gifts. Isn't it? Generally, in such a context, we used to hear that some old women speak about the characteristics of the baby. For example, they will say that the baby has got the face of mother, eyes of father, hairs, ears, color, and so on. Right? Why do they say so? Simple. We know that the baby would have many characters of parents. Some characters would be similar to that of the mother, and some would be similar to that of father. That is, there are some similarities or resemblance between parents and offspring. This is known as inheritance. It is the basis of heredity, that is, similarities between parents and offspring. Okay, but will parents and offspring be 100% similar? Never. Offspring will have many characters that are not seen in parents. That is, there would be some differences between parents and offspring. This is known as variation. Now we understood inheritance, heredity, and variation. Actually, genetics is the study of inheritance, heredity, and variation of characters. Okay, if we observe the body of each person, we can see many characteristic features such as skin color, body height, hair shape, face appearance, eyes, ears, nose, etc. Right? In our body, there are some special substances responsible for producing these characters. Do you know its name? Yes, genes. Genes are responsible for producing these characters. For each character, there would be specific genes. Now you will have two important doubts regarding genes. First one, actually, what kind of substance the gene is? Secondly, where the genes are located in our body? Many of you know the answers of these questions. Anyway, I will explain. All of you know that our body is made up of cells. Each cell contains nucleus. Each nucleus contains some thread-like structures called chromosomes. What is inside a chromosome? A chromosome contains highly complicated chemical compound called DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. Actually, this DNA acts as genes. Okay? But all regions of a DNA do not function as genes. If a specific region of a DNA control a particular character, that region is considered as a gene. We will go for a detailed study about genes and chromosomes later in a chapter called Molecular Basis of Inheritance. Anyway, if we study about genetics, we need to learn about genes and chromosomes. So we can give another definition for genetics. That is, it is the study of genes and chromosomes. Okay? Now, I am asking a question. How the genes are transmitted from parents to offspring? Do you know? Yes, that we had already studied in the chapter Human Reproduction. Father produces sperms which contains 23 chromosomes. Similarly, mother produces ovum or egg which also contains 23 chromosomes. These chromosomes contain all the genes of parents responsible for all characters. When sperm and ovum are fused to form zygote, it gets 23 plus 23, that is 46 chromosomes, which contain all the parental genes. Right? This zygote develops to embryo and finally a baby. Now we have billions of cells in our body. All these cells are formed from the zygote because of the cell division. Clear? Okay, do you remember from where we started our discussion? Yes, we started by talking about a baby born in your family, where one of a lady looked at the eyes of the baby. Its eye color was dark brown. She looked at the eyes of the baby's father. It is also brown in color, but the eye color of mother is blue. Blue eye color. If so, will the baby have a brown color in one eye and blue color in another eye? No. Both eyes are brown colored. What do you understand from this? Firstly, let us see the character we analyzed. No doubt, it's eye color. Eye color is a character. But that character has two variants. What are they? Brown and blue. Actually, eye color has many variants, but here we discuss about two variants only. Okay, such variants are called traits. Let me make it more clear. What is a character? It is a heritable transmitting feature from parents to offspring. For example, eye color. A character will have several variants or forms. It is called traits. Example, brown eye and blue eye colors are traits of the character eye color. Clear? We already understood that each character is controlled by genes. In genetics, generally we use English letters to indicate a gene. Let us again take eye color as an example. We can name the gene of eye color as E. We can give any other suitable letters. Here, I just gave the letter E that indicates the first letter of I. So the gene of eye color is E. Each gene would have more than one forms. Those alternative forms are called alleles. I repeat, alleles are different forms of a gene that control a particular character or function. Just imagine. A chalk is compared to a gene. Its function is writing. Okay. If chalk is a gene, its alleles are white chalk, blue chalk, green chalk, etc. But all are chalks and produce the same character with different traits. Got the point? Okay. Let us come back to the eye color. If the gene of eye color is E, it will have several alleles. That alleles determines the color of eye, whether it is brown or blue or any other color. Here, we understood that the father has brown eye color and mother has blue eye color. It means that the chromosome in sperm produced by father contains allele of brown eye color. Similarly, the chromosome in ovum produced by mother contains allele of blue eye color. When these gametes, that is sperm and ovum, are fused, the chromosomes containing these alleles will be paired in zygote. That chromosome pair is known as homologous pairs. You have already learned about homologous chromosomes in first year. Based on the type of alleles in this chromosome pair, the offspring gets the appropriate eye color. Imagine that the chromosomes in both sperm and ovum contain allele of brown eye color. Then the chromosome pair in zygote will get same allele. Thus, the condition in which a chromosome pair carries similar allele of a gene, it is called homozygous condition. Okay? In the same way, imagine that the chromosomes in both sperm and ovum contain allele of the blue eye color, still the chromosome pair will get the same allele. Allele of blue in both chromosomes. That condition is also homozygous condition. Homo means similar. Now, we can analyze the previously discussed condition. That is, the chromosome in sperm contains allele of brown eye and egg contains allele of blue eye. Then what will be the result of the condition of chromosome pair in zygote? Yes. One chromosome contains brown allele and the other chromosome contains blue allele. This condition is called heterozygous. Hetero means different. Clear? I repeat, the condition in which a chromosome pair carries dissimilar alleles of a gene is called heterozygous condition. Okay? Now, many of you will have a doubt. What is that? When the allele of brown from father and allele of blue from mother are come to the zygote, why did the offspring get only brown eye color? Why didn't he get blue eye color? Or why didn't he get one eye with brown and the other eye with blue? We are going to explain its reason. First of all, you should know that all alleles of a gene have no same power or efficiency. Some alleles will be more efficient or functional, and some will be less efficient or non-functional. An efficient or functional allele is called dominant allele, and the less or non-functional allele is called recessive allele. In genetics, dominant allele is generally indicated with capital letter and recessive allele is with small letter. If so, what about eye color? E is the gene of eye color. So its dominant allele will be capital E and recessive allele will be small e. The character of dominant allele will be expressed in the offspring. It is called dominant character. Similarly, the character of the recessive allele will be suppressed or masked in the offspring. It is called recessive character. Here, we saw that brown eye color is expressed in the baby. It means brown is dominant character. Capital E is dominant allele. Blue color is recessive character. So it is suppressed in offspring. Actually, the allele of blue, that is small e, has inherited to the baby. But it cannot express. It is suppressed. Okay? We have to understand that a character is dominant or recessive is only in the case of heterozygous condition, not in homozygous condition. Because different alleles are paired only in heterozygous condition. In homozygous condition, both alleles are same. Both have same power, same efficiency. That's why we say that the character which is expressed in heterozygous condition is called dominant character. Similarly, the character which is suppressed in heterozygous condition is called recessive character. Okay? Now, we should analyze two more important terms. That is phenotype and genotype. What is a phenotype? It is a visible character or physical expression of a character in an individual. In simple words, a character or effect produced by a gene pair is called phenotype. For example, let us consider eye color again. The gene of eye color is E. It produces the character eye color. Its two alleles include capital E and small e. Okay. When chromosome pair is formed in zygote, these alleles inside these chromosomes also paired. It may be capital E, capital E, capital E, small e, or small e, small e. These are called gene pair or allele pair. Okay. Gene pair produces a character expression in offspring. That is called phenotype. Example, capital E, capital E. It is a gene pair. It produces the phenotype called brown eye. Capital E, small e also produces the phenotype brown eye because small e is recessive. But small e produces the phenotype blue eye. Then what is genotype? It is the genetic constitution of a character. On the other hand, a gene pair that produces a phenotype is called genotype. Okay? In the above example, capital E is a genotype. Capital E, small e is another genotype. Small e is also a genotype. The genotype capital E is homozygous and produces the phenotype brown eye. Capital E, small e is a heterozygous genotype but produces the same phenotype of capital E, that is brown eye color. It means that brown eye color has two genotypes, capital E and capital E, small e, homozygous genotype and heterozygous genotype. Both produces same phenotype. But the phenotype blue eye has only one genotype. That is small e. Okay. Dear students, we discussed here very fundamental terms in genetics. There are many other terms also. We will discuss about them in the coming episodes. This episode ends here. I expect your valuable comments and feedback. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye.